The current challenge is something that we all do not want, and it must never happen. We are losing people, we are losing lives. I believe that working together, we can solve the current situation.
While presenting a statement on the current drug stockout in public health facilities across the country, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng told Parliament that the crisis has been caused by the Minister of Finance, which has delayed to release funds required by the national medical stores to procure medical supplies on time.
Specific reference to this financial year, 2022-2023, actual funds for the first quarter were not available to national medical stores until August 2022. In the second quarter, funds were not available until the first week of November 2022.
Acheng noted that several engagements have been made to the Minister of Finance to resolve the long-lasting impasse, but nothing tangible has been realized.
Right, Honorable Speaker, Honorable Members, effective financial year 2019-2020, the Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development directed that all financial transactions of national medical stores, that is procurements and distributions, must be effected through IFMIS.
Acheng noted that the entity is suffering with a deficit of 7 billion shillings on its distribution budget, and many of its trucks can hardly deliver medical supplies to health facilities.
For motor vehicles, we are not paid on time, and on several occasions, they cut off service delivery due to late payments. Vehicles could not move, and other vehicles that were already in the field got stuck in the field. B, the last mile delivery provider, that is the provider that picks from the districts and takes to the lower health facilities, was not paid on time. The delayed payments affected the ability of the provider.
As the Minister of Health seeks exemptions of national medical stores from IFMIS systems that are blamed for delayed funding of procurement of medical supplies, the Minister of Finance, Henry Mosasizi, rejected the prayer, saying national medical stores has to abide by the Public Finance Management Act. Mosasizi also hit back at national medical stores, wondering how it has failed to deliver drugs, yet it has already received 60% of its budget in releases of quarter one and quarter two.
NMS does not want to belong to the IFMIS system. So the question I ask is that under which law do I implement the decisions you make here?
MPs expressed frustration over what they termed a politically motivated fight of egos among the ministers responsible. These wondered how a fight of a kind could cost lives.
The Ministry of Finance, together with the Ministry of Health, are involved in battles that are also affecting our people on ground. Because right now, if the Minister of Finance cannot release the required funds for the to the Ministry of Health to transport and move the medicines to the district quarters or to any place where they are needed, it means the people's lives, those people that are supposed to receive a service, are going to be put at a risk.
We have a problem with the integrated financial management system, yes. At the district level, they are being inefficient, but on another side, I have a problem with NMS. You can't say they give you 500 billion to be spent outside the Finance Management Act. The minister can't do that.
When two elephants fight, it is the grass that suffers. When the two ministries are fighting, especially finance and health, because the health ministry is supposed to get money from the finance ministry to ensure that they avail drugs to our people. When these two are fighting, it means our people on ground that we represent are not going to get the medication on time. We have received calls quite a number of times, people telling us they do not have drugs. Even the health workers themselves do not have, they don't know what to do.
The impasse left Parliament concerned and confused, and the presiding officer, Thomas Taiwa, directed the Prime Minister to resolve the dispute between the two ministries and report back to Parliament tomorrow. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.